Hi, my name is Hal Sharp, and I welcome you to this Bushido series. Most of this footage I shot in the early 50s while living in Japan, where I developed a passion for Japanese culture, especially the martial arts. I hope you'll enjoy these productions as much as I enjoy sharing my past with you. Now, step on the mat and meet my senseis. Japan was devastated by World War II. Martial arts were forbidden by the Allies until 1947. Japan hoped to build a bridge of friendship by sharing its culture with the rest of the world. These films were made in 1951 through 1956 during the period of Japan's recovery. This film hopes to keep the bridge of friendship alive. Judo in the 1950s. Imagine a world without television or computers and no International Judo Federation rules. Most judo competitions were based on ippon scoring only. The senseis you'll see in this film practiced daily. When they threw you, the first sensation was going through the air. On the mat, they played with you like a parent with a child. Sometimes all you can move was your eyeballs. How could you not help but respect and love these senseis? Hi, I'm Hal Sharp. Over 50 years ago, I was a young judo student in Japan. My senseis were like my parents, and I became a part of their family and dojo. At that time, I never thought about getting old and could not imagine my senseis never being on the mat with me again. Now, I am almost 80 years old, and my senseis are no longer with me. In order to keep their teachings and friendship alive, I will now try to show and tell you about them and how I benefited from knowing them. This film is dedicated to Jigoro Kano. He founded judo over 120 years ago. He was the sensei of my senseis, and they told me what a wonderful guy he was. Here he is sitting with his wife and family. And now we go to Berlin, the 1936 Olympics, with the sensei standing next to Jesse Owens, the American legend. This is a statue of Sensei Kano at the new Kodokan today. History of Kata. Before judo, the martial arts such as jiu-jitsu, taijutsu, yuwara, torete were taught with the object of defeating their opponent. Because these techniques could cause injury or death, their practice was performed using cooperative, prearranged drills called kata. Judo's system of katas evolved from katas of the past. In the old days, martial arts systems were documented in scrolls with brief descriptions or drawings. The following drawings were selected from a system called Kobudo, meaning ancient martial arts. You will notice how similar these techniques are to Kodokan Judo today. Throughout this video, the terms tori and uke will be used. Tori means the doer, like the one who does the throwing. Uke means receiver, like the one who was thrown. The tori cross grips the uke's lapel. Then he pulls him hard, swings him up on his back, pulls with his right hand, and sweeps up with his left hand. It's like katagaruma. Tori steps deep and low behind uke and pulls him down to throw him backwards. The other drawing shows him reaching around the waist, grabbing the hilt of the sword or dagger to keep him from drawing it. Here, Tori uses his foot to get a coil arm bar on uke and pressing down on his shoulder. On the right, he cross grips the lapels, preparing to throw him. On the left, he grabs his wrist, slams across his throat, throws him behind his leg for a sukinage. On the right, he finishes him off with a chokehold. On the left, he chokes from behind using the opponent's collar. On the right, he's doing a cross choke from the front. Here, the Tory does a cross choke from the bottom, uses his legs to control the opponent and then to shove his body away. On the left, he pins the opponent and then hooks his arm, then crosses his legs over the top to do a cross arm bar called Jujigatami. Here he hits the opponent with an uppercut, then he grabs his wrist and elbow and takes him straight down on his face. On the left, he deflects a blow with his elbow. On the right, he avoids a punch, drops low, and hits the opponent in the kidneys. On the left, he does a wrist lock and arm bar from the bottom. From the right, he does a wrist lock from the top. Here, he controls the opponent on his back by hooking his leg, then reaches across the neck for holding and choking. Before the judo katas, there were katas practiced by the other martial arts. This is a film of Kobudo ancient martial arts still practiced in Japan. The players begin with a low salutation, keeping an eye on each other. Now the Tori is going to deliver some sake to the uke. Puts it down. Uke goes to reach for the glass. Tori grabs his wrist, does kote gaeshi, a wrist twist, then strikes him. As the players finish, you notice when they bow, they keep looking at each other. Here's the Tori serving sake. As Uke reaches for it, he grabs his wrist, twists his wrist, goes into a wrist lock, pushes down on the elbow, and then kicks him. Again, in this routine, Tori is going to deliver sake to the Uke. In this case, he throws it at the Uke, kicks him down, and strikes him. Uke grabs Tori, comes out with a knife. Tori deflects the knife, takes him down into a wrist lock and arm bar, takes away the knife and returns it. Again, Uke grabs Tori, comes through with a knife from underneath. Tori deflects the knife, gets a wrist lock, takes away the knife and returns it. As they bow, Tori grabs Uke's wrist, reaches under the jacket, under the armpit. It's a wrist lock. Kicks him between the legs, takes him down, maintaining the wrist lock, also locking his arm. Tori throws the sake at the uke, pulls a knife, kicks him down, holds his arm for control, and the knife in the throat. Uke draws a knife. Tori grabs his elbow and wrist, takes him down into an armbar. Tori throws the sake at uke, draws a knife, attacks Uke, but Uke deflects with his fan. This is a demonstration of Iaijutsu, the art of drawing a sword. Thank you. This is a sword drawing kata. Tori steps to the side and cuts across the ribs. In this kata, the Tori blocks the Uke's arm and thrusts to the throat. This demonstrates how the players finish. They cross swords, face each other, then return their swords to the scabbards. Tori blocks Uke's sword with the handle, pushes it down, then cuts across the stomach. Uke jumps, strikes, Tori blocks, then thrusts for the throat. Uke grabs Tori's sword by the handle. They struggle. Tori kicks him down, draws a sword, and strikes. This is the bow or long staff against the sword. Again, here is the bow against the sword. Twirls it, slams the ground, making the opponent jump, and then thrusts to the throat. Here the swordsman tries to avoid the bow, goes down, comes to the side, and gets his opponent. Here the Tori blocks with the staff, comes under the opponent's arm, and throws him. Here the swordsman jumps up and down to avoid the bow, then parries the bow. Here is a drill with the swordsman against the naginata, which is the long shaft with a curved blade. Here the swordsman jumps to avoid the naginata blade, parries, and then thrusts. Here the swordsman frantically jumps up and down to avoid the naginata blade. But the player with the naginata hooks his head, throws him down, and hits him with the back end. This is the jo, which is the shorter staff against the swordsman. This is the chigiriki, which is a staff with a chain and a leaded ball at the end. Here the chain and ball is used to make the swordsman jump, and then the staff is used. Now the ball is whipped around the opponent's leg. Let's try that again. Here we go. And the opponent is pulled down. Then, of course, the staff is used to clobber the opponent. Now the chain and weight are used to wrap around the swordsman's sword and disarm him. Here the sword is parried with the staff, and then the chain and weight is wrapped around the opponent's neck and he's brought to the ground. Here's another view of the chain going around the neck. The sword is blocked with the staff, then the legs are knocked out with the back of the staff, and then the opponent is hit on the head with the weight. The opponents bow. Tori stands up, approaches Uke from the rear, attacks Uke with his hand around the chin. Uke draws a knife. Tori deflects the knife, takes him down into an armbar, and disarms him. Tori blocks the knife and throws with an ippon sioinage, and then kicks the arm. Tori throws Uke with an upside-down kataguruma, and then kicks him. Here is a sword kata, cutting the opponent's forearm. Tori blocks Huke's arm, throws him down, draws a sword, and aims for the head. Huke draws fast, Tori sidesteps and cuts his side. Tori blocks Huke at the elbow, throws him down, attacks with his fan, Huke grabs his wrist, and throws him with the circular throw to Morinage. These gentlemen were kind enough to let me film them and see their ancient arts. Judo katas are prearranged drills to study the techniques, theory of form, and self-defense. The randori katas cover nagi no kata, throwing forms, katami no kata, forms of grappling. The form katas are the forms of five, and juno kata, the forms of gentleness. And the fighting katas are koshiki no kata, the forms of antique, kimi no kata, forms of decision, and goshin jitsu, self-defense.
This is nage no kata, forms of throwing. It consists of hand throws, hip throws, foot throws, straight sacrifice, and side sacrifice throws. The players are required to do 15 techniques, both right side and left side. This is a shot of a beautiful okuryashibarai, or foot sweep.
Asami Sensei was my teacher and friend. He was one of the head instructors at the Keishicho Taekwon, which is the Tokyo Metropolitan Police Academy. He also was at the Kodokan, and I was a member of his dojo. Here he's demonstrating kimi no kata at the All Japan Championship. Sitting around the table in the foreground is Watanabe, myself, Asami, and Kobayashi. Under this table is a kotatsu. It's a hole in the ground with charcoals on a grate. Later you'll see when he's practicing judo, Asami has a bandage on his toe. I said, Sensei, is that from judo? He says, no, from the kotatsu. No, from judo.
Each kata starts with salutation, first bowing to the head table, then kneeling down to bow to each other. Then stands up, take one step forward to signify they're ready to fight. First technique is ukiyotoshi, floating drop. They are required to do both right side and left side, as you can see. Next technique is soinage, shoulder throw. Use the momentum of the strike to execute the throw. Following soinage is kataguruma, shoulder wheel. Very powerful technique. After completing the three techniques, each player will go to his corner, fix his gi, then to continue with the next set. The first technique is ukigoshi. This happens to be Kano Sensei's very favorite technique. Ukigoshi, floating hip throw, had a flaw. player could simply step around to avoid the technique. Then, harai-goshi, or the sweeping hip throw, was developed to counter this action. Harai-goshi, the sweeping hip throw, also had a flaw. It could be avoided by stiffening one's body. The next technique, which is tsurikomi-goshi, inducing hip throw, was developed to counteract that defense. Next series of techniques deals with foot. The first technique will be okuri-ashi-barai, or foot sweep. This is a great equalizer. No matter what the size of the opponent, it could be easily done to offset their balance. After foot sweep comes inducing foot block, sasae-tsurikomi-ashi. You block the advancing opponent's foot, thus offsetting their balance again. Last of the foot series is uchimata. Today, we typically use this technique as koshiwaza, hip technique, versus foot technique, but it originated as a foot technique. Now we move to sacrifice throw. The first series will be straight sacrifice throw. The first technique is the stomach throw. You might see John Wayne doing this in the movies. After the stomach throw is the backward throw, uranage. You might see some wrestlers doing this on TV. The last of the sacrifice throw is the inside leg flip. This technique typically is used to render the opponent into the ground to apply a hold technique. The last series of naginokata is the sai sacrifice throw. The first technique is the sai block, yokogake. As you can see, the uke, or the person taking fall, falls violently, and if they don't take care to hold their head up, it will hurt. The next technique is yokoguruma, side wheel. Use a sideward momentum to throw your opponent. And finally, the last technique, ukiwaza, floating technique. This exemplifies the term sacrifice. Use your body to flip your opponent to the side. At the end of the performance, each player shows respect to each other by bowing from the seating position, then stands up and bow to the head table or to the audience to show respect.
Tatami no kata, forms of holding. There are 5 hold down techniques, 5 choking techniques, 4 arm locks, and 1 leg lock technique. Daigo demonstrates katami no kata at the Kodokan's Kagami Baraki. Kawakami Sensei now gives a lesson in katami no kata. I will be the tori, and his son Rei will be the uke. First, we have the sensei demonstrating kami shiho katami. Goes into position, the uke tries to escape. Sensei uses his legs as outriggers to stop the action. And now it's my turn to demonstrate katami no kata. This is a very slow kata. Step about 6 feet away, go down into a half kneeling, shinny up. Now I'll demonstrate Kuzurei Keisa Katami, a modified cross chest hold. Slide into position. Uke will try to escape. Now I go into Katami no Kata, a shoulder hold. After the hold, I put his arm back in place. Then I change positions, and now I'm in Kami Shiho Katami, similar to what the sensei showed. Upper four corner hold. Okuriri Jime, the sliding collar choke. And now we do the half sided choke. Kataha Jime. Bring his arm behind his back. It's like a single wing. Now we change positions. And I start to do a cross choke from the top. Uke will grab me, start to turn me over. I'll roll on my back and choke him from the bottom. Now we start a new series. We're going into the arm locks. Uke turns around. I want to move to the side. Take his arm out of the way. First technique, he reaches for me, and I do a coil arm lock, Uregarami. And the opponent taps. Then I do Jujigatami, the cross arm bar. Then I return his arm. Now I take his arm out of the way, he reaches for me, and I do a straight arm bar, Uregatami. Juno Kata, the forms of gentleness, developed by the founder Jigoro Kano to show the action and reaction of forces between two players. Miss Fukuda is one of the most remarkable judo people in the world today. She's now 92 years old, ninth dan, still practices and teaches judo. Her great-grandfather, Hachinosuke Fukuda, was one of the 3 influential masters of jiu-jitsu who taught the founder of judo, Jigoro Kano Shihan, in his formative years. Here in 1951, she's a 5th-degree black belt and practicing randori with her students. Here is Fukuda Sensei in 1953, standing next to Lindy Avakan, who was 5'10", 200 pounds. And here she is a few years later, next to Sensei Rei Kawakami, who was about 5'5". Here is a beautiful portrait of the sensei by the artist Dr. Poposi Joe Bandor. Dr. Kano smiling down upon her as she stands in front of the Kodokan symbol. And here she is at the age of 92, standing in front of her portrait. Juno Kata, the forms of gentleness, demonstrated by Miss Noritomi and Miss Fukuda in 1951 at the Kodokan. This is really a beautiful kata. What's interesting about this is that in no event is any partner thrown.
First technique in Juno kata is tsukidashi, forward thrust, simulated by the uke's knife edge hand. The tori parries to the side, avoiding the thrust, now leans back, tries to put uke into submission. Uke takes over control and tries to put tori into submission, in which tori again takes over, leaning back and placing the uke into submission. Uke will now push the shoulder of the tori. Tori will bend forward, backing up slightly. Then uke will thrust to the bridge of the nose. Tori deflects, grabs the wrist, and places the uke into submission. Uke strikes tori. Tori parries, thrust, then turns to perform uranage, or backward throw. This is simulating someone grabbing your hand from the side. Tori breaks uke's balance by pulling laterally, then performs ukigoshi, or floating hip throw. The two warriors will charge at each other with weapons raised high. Tori will sidestep, shaking uke side to side, dislodging the weapon, finally raising the arm high to immobilize the uke.
Here is an archive film from the turn of the 20th century with Kano and Mifune doing Juno kata. Thank you.
Kano Shihan developed Itsutsu no Kata, forms of five, in 1887. There's no names for the forms, just numbers. It applies the forces of nature to the theory of judo. First form shows even a small force can overturn a heavy object. Second form shows the effect of maximum efficiency. Third form emulates effect of ocean whirlpool turning faster and faster. Fourth is the wave rolling on shore, sweeping away everything in its path. The last principle is nothing ventured, nothing gained. Mifune Sensei will approach the uke, who is acting as a stone statue. He will place his palm on the chest, then push it side to side, eventually knocking the statue over. Here we have both Tori and uke acting as a whirlpool, spinning faster and faster and faster. The last form is depicting two objects in a collision course. Nothing ventured, nothing gained, thus avoiding collision.
Mifune Sensei was considered a living legend. He's probably the best known judoka the world has ever known. Here he is with a group of other high ranking senseis. Mifune is now doing Itsutsu no Kata, the forms of five, at the All Japan Championship. Here he is working out with Maurice Gruel, who was over 200 pounds at the Kodokan. Maurice tries to throw him. Mifune just smiles and swings up on his back. Now this is at a numazu at a new dojo. He's explaining Itsutsu no Kata, the forms of five, and other katas. He's with Kiyoshi Kobayashi. This is the form that looks like an airplane where they turn around with their arms spread apart. He says if you don't continue, it dies. So you keep going, drop down. There's the one like the wave across his chest. Now this one is where two opponents come at each other. He says if you don't get out of the way, you're in trouble. So here's what he does. Drops down. The opponent goes over him. Now he's going to explain how to move with an opponent, counter throws, picking up someone's weakness. This is where Kobayashi has more or less attempted to do a ukiyotoshi, a hand technique. So Mifune Sensei is explaining his weak points. He can kick his leg out, osoto, from the back like he just did, or he can step forward and throw him over his back leg. There he goes. He shows the action. Now Kobayashi's trying a one-arm shoulder throw. So Mifune explains, since his force is forward, you can swing around the front and throw him with a stemi waza. Now here, if Kobayashi tries an obi otoshi, picking him up, as he grabs the belt, grab him and do a leg sweep. That's an oguruma. Now they're moving around. As the opponent stops, he does tomoe nage. Moving around some more. Kobayashi tries to throw. He swings around the back. Tries again. That was a great oguruma there. Kobayashi tries a kouchi. Tries another throw. Mifune just bounces off of him. They move around some more. Mifune bounces off of him. Mifune drops under him quickly for a Katagaruma. This is Mifune at the first World's Judo Championship doing Itsutsu no Kata. That was the wave form. Now the two opponents rise, they spread their arms, and they come at each other. Mifune drops.
Koshiki no kata, the ancient forms, designed to be performed with men in armor. You may notice the stiff form as they simulate fighting hand-to-hand combat in armor. Here is Asami Sensei and Yves Klein Sensei performing Koshiki no Kata. You will note the unusual seating position. This is the way samurai warriors sat with their armor. Tai, the ready position. Uke attacks from the rear, attempting to throw the tori in hip throw. Uke will swing his leg high to maximize the swing movement to throw the tori. Tori counters and throwing the uke to the rear. Notice the knee position. This simulates breaking the uke's back on his knees. Yumenouchi, dreaming. In this situation, the uke, resisting the throw to the back, will lean forward. The tori now can perform the backward throw or the uranage. Ryokuhi, strength dodging. Uke reaches forward to steal the tori's swords. Tori sidesteps and controls uke's elbow. Uke then counters by standing up straight and allowing the tori to throw the uke to the back. Mizuguruma, water wheel. Uke again tries to steal the tori's sword. Tori pulls the uke forward, forcing the uke to retreat. Then tori places the uke's hand to his face and throws the uke with backward throw, uranage. Mizunagare, water flow. Uke reaches to grab the tori's chest plate. Before the uke has chance to stab the tori with a hidden weapon to the back, the tori throws the uke with floating drop, uki otoshi. Hiki otoshi, pulling drop. As the uke reaches forward, the tori steps to the back and throws the uke with floating drop, uki otoshi. Kodaure, log fall. Tori attacks the uke's face. Uke then parries. The tori grabs the uke's belt, raises the hand against the face, and uses the knee to trip the uke backwards. Uchikudaki, smashing. Tori attacks the uke's stomach. Uke parries, then tori lifts the uke by the belt to smash the uke's back across his knees using obiotoshi or belt drop. Tani otoshi, valley drop. Uke tries to smash tori into the ground. Tori seizes the uke's fingers and reverse grips the belt. Then tori lifts uke high to drop uke's back across the knee. Kuruma daore, wheel throw. Uke forces tori to turn. Tori turns and hooks under uke's armpits, lifting uke up and forward to perform backward throw, uranage. Shikoro dori, grabbing the neck. Uke grabs tori's belt. Tori pulls uke's wrist and simultaneously twists uke's face using chin as leverage. Then tori pulls the uke's shoulder to smash the uke's back across tori's knee. Shikoro gaeshi, twisting the neck plates. Uke grabs tori's belt. As the uke is pulling on the belt, tori using both hands on uke's head breaks uke's neck. then pulls on Uke's shoulder to throw him into the ground. Yudachi, rain shower. Tori grabs Uke's kimono just above the breastplate. Using the knuckle, tries to break the Uke's throat. Uke pushes forward to defend. Tori throws Uke with floating drop, Uki Otoshi. Taki Otoshi, waterfall drop. Tori grabs the Uke's kimono just above the breastplate again. This time, Uke tries Koshiguruma, hip wheel, to counter. Tori counters with backward throw, Ranage. Mikudaki, body smashing. Uke approaches Tori from the rear and tries a hip throw. Tori grabs the wrist and places left arm under the Uke's armpit, then performs side separation throw, Yokowakare. Kurumagaeshi, wheel throw. Uke approaches Tori and pushes Tori. Tori simply counters with backward throw, Uranage. Mizuiri, water plunge. Uke tries to push Tori with right hand. Tori counters with side separation throw, Yokowakare. Ryusetsu, willow snow. Tori brushes hand across Uke's face, causing Uke to lean back, then applies backward throw, Uranage. Sakaotoshi, headlong fall. Uke, using hand to simulate dagger, thrusts into Tori's stomach. Tori parries and performs Ukiotoshi, the floating drop throw. Yukiore, snow break. Uke attacks from the rear, then Tori throws Uke with a shoulder throw. Ippon Sei Otoshi. Iwanami, waves on the rocks. Tori brushes both hands across Uke's face, causing Uke to lean back. Then grabs both lapel to throw Uke with backward throw, Uranage.
Last of the living tenthons in Japan. And now we cover some more. Here's some more sensei sitting at the head table at a tournament. To his right is Mifune sensei. Some more sensei here is doing a Koshiki no Kata with Koyasu. And here's a series of photos out of a 100-year-old judo book. This is when Samura was a young man. The book was published in 1915. This is Samura with Shibayama sensei, who you'll see later, his son, and me in the background. Samura doing Ogoshi, Yokostemi, and Ippon Sei Nage, high on the shoulder, the old-fashioned way. In the 1956 All Japan Championships, Koshiki no Kata was demonstrated by Samura and Yamaguchi. Now let's see what it really looks like. Thank you. This is Nagaoka Sensei, 10th Dan, doing a Koshigi no Kata demonstration at the 1951 All Japan Championship. Nagaoka Sensei passed away the next year in 1952.
Goshin Jutsu evolved from Jujitsu, Kimi no Kata, as you see here, Aikido, Taiho Jutsu, police tactics, and finally into Kodokan's new modern self-defense called Goshin Jutsu. There it is.
Kimi no Kata, decisive technique forms. These are the old-fashioned self-defense techniques using the hand, dagger, and sword. Okay, attacks with the knife. Tori blocks it, throws him with a one-arm shoulder throw. Okay, attacks with the sword. Tori deflects it, crosses the arms. Disarms Uke, then throws him with a hand throw. Uke grabs the hilt of the sword. Tori twists Uke's arm, takes him down into an armbar called Wakigatami. Here, Uke grabs Tori's jacket. Tori grabs his wrist, kicks him, twists the wrist, and takes him down into a wrist lock. Here are a few Kimi no Kata moves. Ukegoshi, a throw. Now you'll have a choke from behind. Blocks, chokes, and then a kick. Tomiki Sensei developed a system of Aikido to be used by judoka. It later evolved into a system of self-defense called Goshin Jitsu. Here he is teaching Air Force MPs. Yamada Sensei will be showing Tomiki's system. First, Yamada will be showing some drills. Attack and defense. You notice how he uses what's called the hand sword. Bends his arm about 45 degrees. Can use it for throwing. Here a student is demonstrating the walking exercise. Sensei stops him, corrects him, says keep your head straight, your body straight. Abdomen forward, very important. There he is. Pushing off to go forward, pushing back to go back. And here's the sensei, back and forth. When you go forward, you push off with the back leg. When you go back, you push off with the, and then sideways, the same thing. Push off with one leg. And then stepping in and around, going forward, then stepping back and around, going backwards. And here's the sidestepping exercises. These are really quite easy to do. This is a close-up of his feet. Pushes forward, steps back. This is the way swordsmen move, then sideways to avoid an opponent. Stepping around when you go forward, then stepping back and avoiding an opponent. Sort of like a bullfighter. Now he blocks from inside, goes again, and against the chin. Now a block from inside again, the other side, and against the chin. In, against the chin, with the hand sword. In, against the chin, on the left side. From the outside, blocking from the elbow and against the head. Block, come across, push down. Block, come across, push down. Opponent grabs your wrist, go into the hand sword, pull them around. You can do it from the outside or the inside. That's an inside move, an inside move. From the outside, and the outside. It's like square dancing. Outside, outside, inside, inside. There you are, inside again. And this is like square dancing. One does it to one and the other one does it to the other. This is coming across the head with one hand. Over and across. That throws the opponent backwards. From the other side. From the inside. And from the inside. Same type of technique. You just can't go wrong. Whichever way is easiest, it'll work. That's pulling an opponent forward, catching him, and just snapping from the inside and from the outside. He did it from the outside first, then the inside. Inside, blocking. Outside. Outside. Inside. Inside. Outside.
With two hands. And turns it, and that really hurts. Around, twist the wrist. It just shows how easy it is to throw. Here's with a wrist twist called Kote Gaishi. Just to demonstrate the opponent's weakness. Bending the wrist takes him back. And now we do the drills again. Catching, twisting, turning. I did this for 30 days every morning with him. It was really fun. Taiho Jutsu, Police Self-Defense by Sensei Hosogawa Seventh Dan. This series includes defense against the sword, which was the Yakuza's still chosen weapon, the knife, gun, punching, choking, and other barehanded attacks. Hosogawa Sensei now demonstrates Taiho Jutsu against a sword from the inside, from the outside against a sword. And the reason using the sword is because that was a weapon of choice for the Yakuza, even in those days. Then he takes him into a wrist lock from the outside and across the ribs. From the outside and across the ribs again. Then he blocks the opponent's arm. He's trying to draw a knife out. He catches him before the knife can come out, then into a wrist lock. Blocks the arm from the bottom, takes him back, twists his wrist, puts his knee in his shoulder. Blocks him again with his baton, takes him down again for an arm lock. This is almost like an osoto. This catches the arm with the knife, takes him back, pushes him down, avoids the thrust, hits him, twists the wrist, brings him around, hits the hand, disarms him, grabs the wrist. Again, same type of thing, brings him back, twists the wrist, disarms him, and now he's going to do a come-along hold. And that really hurts. That's how he does the come-along. Twist the wrist, brings it up underneath, and then to add a little pain, just push the finger out. Avoids the knife, hits, takes him down into an arm bar, disarms him. These are disarming techniques against a pistol. Grabs a pistol, turns it away, hits the opponent. Now let's see this slowly. Catches the pistol, turns the barrel away so he can't get shot, turns it into the opponent, and strikes him. Here's another technique. From the outside, pulls it across the opponent and hits him across the back of the head as he disarms him. There he goes. And then he brings the pistol back. Another technique. This is with a wrist twist, like Kote Gaishi. Slowly. Pull the pistol away, twist the wrist back, hold on to the pistol, now you have it. Pistol in the back, turn around, hook, and take the pistol away. Slowly now. Turn, hook, bend the arm back, take the pistol. Block, like Oso Togari. Now these are barehanded techniques. Like Sodetsudi Kamigoshi. And he takes him into a wrist lock, doing it slow, over the top, against the choke. Blocks the arm, throws again, like Osoto. From the back, twists out, arm bar. Then into a come along. Around the neck, turns out, slowly. Around, turns out, into an arm bar. Hits, comes in, Yokoguruma. Hits the balls, swings through, and throws him. Now he pulls his hair, hits him in the ribs, kicks him, throws him with Osoto, goes into an armbar. Goshin Jutsu, the Kodokan Modern Self-Defense System. Tori is Tomiki Seventh Dan, Uke Otaki Seventh Dan. This is a demonstration at the 1956 All Japan Championship. Here are a few still shots from the demonstration. Defense against a knife. Another one against the knife. Defense against a stick.
disarming a pistol, against a punch, doing osotogari. This is the first public demonstration in 1956 at the Kodokan Kagami Baraki. Now let's really watch him do it.